Hello and welcome to day 22 of the Halloween Craft Countdown, where I'm releasing a new Cricut craft every day for the whole of October. Today we are making these cauldron cards, and this is a really cute handmade card which is covered in gemstones and sequins and fancy things to look like the potion coming out of the cauldrons. This is a Design Space project, so for Cricut users you'll be able to open this right up and cut with your Cricut machine. If you have some other brand of cutting machine, or if you don't have one at all, this is a fairly simple design which you can cut by hand, so I'll put instructions for that in the step-by-step written tutorial, and you can find the link to that and the Design Space project in the description of this video. So let's open Design Space and find out how to cut this fancy little cauldron card. I've cut everything out now, so it's time to start assembling my card. For each of the three squares, we've got the biggest square, and I've cut this out of silver metallic card. I'm not sure if you can see, but that is silver. Then you've got the smaller square, which I've done from white hammered effect card, and the cauldron. To start with, I'm going to glue the white piece to the middle of the silver bit. And you could use double-sided tape or 3D foam pads, but because I've got mirror card, it tends to not play ball with double-sided tape very well, so glue tends to give a better stick. So I'm just going to put that slap bang in the middle, line it up. Next, for the cauldron, I want a bit of depth to this, so I'm going to add it on with a 3D foam pad. Okay, here are my pads. I'm just going to grab one of them, put it on the back of the cauldron, and then stick the cauldron near the bottom of the white card. Now it's time for the fun bit, and that is putting all of the gemstones and sequins to resemble the potion bubbling out of the cauldron. So I've got a range of sticky gemstones and sequins here, and this one I'm going to do with green bubbles. So let's have a little look at what I've got. I think I'll put a couple of big ones on first, and then fill in the gaps with the smaller things. Okay. That doesn't appear to have any sticky left on it. If you need to, you can add just a tiny bit of glue. My glue's now not coming out. Helpful. There we are. A bit of glue will help stick things on. Let's add something else there, and then I'll put a couple of sequins on it. Let's put another one of those up there. Open up my sequins. So I think for this card it's nice to have a range of different embellishments. So sequins are good, and of course the gemstones and all the different colours. If you had some tiny buttons, they might work, or even just take a hole punch and punch out some different shades of green card in little circles. I think that would be really cute. So I'm just positioning these so it looks like that cauldron is bubbling over with exciting potion. Let's see what else I've got. Got these green ones, a bit darker green. This is quite fiddly because they're all small and most of them are sticky on the back, so they're kind of getting in each other's way a little. I've got these really tiny ones. No, I've stuck it to itself. For the really small ones, something like a pricking tool or your Cricut weeding tool can be helpful. If you just get it on the end of there, and it can make it easier to put into place. My gemstones, some of these are really old, like over 10 years old, so they've lost their stickiness a bit. Alright, so this is nearly done. I'm just going to add a few teeny tiny gems to look like the fumes of the potion coming off. Oops, just lodged that sequin. And then what I like to do is to just, if you've got two gemstones that look kind of similar, but one's a bit smaller than the other, just add two, one under the other, to kind of act like a little potion drip. There we go. Okay, that potion is done. Let's move all this out the way. And then I've already done the other two. So I've got a purple one and a red one. And now I can add these to my card. So here's my card front. And you'll see this is a shop bought envelope, but my card will fit nicely in there. And I'm going to, once again, add some 3D foam pads to give these a bit of dimension. I'm going to put them in the order that I want first and roughly line them up on the card so that I know they're all going to fit. So let's just get these roughly where I want them to go. There we go. And then I will start with the top and put some foam pads on the back. Usually I'd cut my foam pads a bit smaller, as these ones are quite big, but because these topper things are quite heavy with all the gemstones, and I've used mirror card, which is heavy. Oh look, there was glue on there. Oh dear. Sorted. So because I've used heavy cardstock and all those gemstones, I'm going to keep my foam pads big to make sure I have the most grip possible. So let's make that the right way round and put it where I want it to go. And for now, I'm just going to kind of lightly drop it into place rather than sticking it down, just in case I need to move it in a minute. So I'm going to do the same thing with all of these foam pads. Let's take this one in the middle, and again I'm just kind of lightly dropping it into place so that if I need to, I can pick it up and move it. Put that into place, and I'm just going to move this a bit closer so I can see it better. I think I've managed to stick every single one of those on wonky. I'm rubbish at sticking things on straight. So you can just play about with the positioning to get them where you want them to go. When you're happy, just push down to seal all those foam pads in place. So that's my card, and you could leave it like that, or you could add some peel-off stickers along the edges. I'm just going to put the lid on my glue. So I think just a little bit of glitz down the side will look quite nice. So let's take my peel-off sticker and, oops, just put it down the edge. It's not quite long enough, so I'll have to join two together. That's one. And then just complete that down the bottom and do the other side. I just need to extend it a bit where it wasn't quite long enough with another one. Chop it off, and there we are. So here is my super duper sparkly witch's cauldron handmade card all finished. So I hope you've enjoyed watching this video. If you have, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my YouTube channel for loads more Cricut craft tutorials and loads more Halloween cards and crafts. I'm releasing a new Halloween craft video every day in October, so be sure to check those out as there are loads more projects to choose from. Thank you for watching!